Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. I had a whole bunch of half-written ideas for this cold open. I had like a celebrity mashup thing. Elton John, Rodgers, and Hammerstein. I was going to do this thing with the Transformers theme, where I go, John Rodgers, more than meets the eye. And then I have something here that just says hot makeout session, but I don't... Let's just begin, shall we? Leverage creator John Rodgers joins us today right here in Outlook, Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Geek, from the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, 1976. A carnival performer who performs sensationally morbid or disgusting acts, such as biting off the head of a live chicken. Geek, the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, 2007. A person intensely interested in a particular field or hobby, generally at the expense of broader social interaction, often used with an attributive noun, such as computer geek. Geek, The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, 2042. A social archetype which, by the early 21st century, had overtaken all others as the dominant influence upon popular culture, entertainment, and the elaborations on and assimilation of technology, consumer and otherwise. See also Wheaton, Will, Colton, Jonathan, and the man to Rick Emerson's immediate right. He is the creator, showrunner, writer, and mastermind behind Leverage, the television series filmed right here in Portland, Oregon. He's written or co-written screenplays for such movies as Transformers and The Core, and he contributed to the fourth edition Dungeons & Dragons Manual of the Planes, and apparently just to spike the ball and or run up the scoreboard, holds a degree in physics. Mr. John Rodgers, welcome to Outlook Portland.
Thank you for having me back, Rick.
Thank you for sitting through the longest introduction in the history of the medium.
I loved watching the architecture of it. It was beautiful. It was like the inception of introductions. It was lovely.
Before we say anything else, we should actually mention that Leverage has just been renewed for
right.
Fourth season.
Fourth season. We found out Friday that we are going to do another 15-episode season, probably up here in Portland.
So congratulations.
Thank you.
Does the anxiety about that sort of a thing ever go away or even diminish a little bit?
I think the second to third season transition is where it goes away. First season, it's all the episodes of the show you've had in your head since you started thinking about the show. Second season, it's all the ones you didn't do first season. Third season, it's, wow, we have to come up with some new stuff. And that's really where you start to crack the show open and see how long the run is. Once you go from second to third season, you can run as long as you want if you make that transition well. So now looking at fourth season, yeah, it's a little nervous to think we have to do 15 more of these, but at the same time, you know, we know how the system works now. We know who the characters are. The fan base is growing as people catch up with it on DVD, which is a very new phenomenon in television. So the audience is coming knowing as much about the show as we do. So we can play around with it a little bit more. I did an episode this year at the end of the season that you never could have done first or second year.
So I should ask, because you're obviously a consumer of television and popular culture as well as somebody who contributes to it, do you mentally measure yourself against other series and where they were in their first, second, or third season, what kinds of things they were doing?
No, not really, because, well, for us it's difficult because there's not many shows like us. We're a con and heist show. You know, we look at Rockford Files, It Takes a Thief, you got Eddie Albert's Switch in the 70s. I mean, that's it. The genre has not been super popular in the United States. Then you look at... A-Team, which I like to think we're a little more grounded and accessible than A-Team. We don't make a van every single week. We make a con with our brain welding rather than a van. So the other combinations are you should look at shows like maybe Hustle, but Hustle does like six episodes a year and also does a much smaller scale. No. I know guys who definitely look at other genre shows and compare, but each show is its own animal.
What you should avoid is anything where Buffy goes off to college and has relations with a big thick-necked jock.
You know, by the way, Mark Blucas, not a bad actor. Not a bad actor, but unfortunate. These unfortunate things occur. And really, fifth season, you can let fifth season slide when you got sixth season sitting right there in the Buffy and the Buffy mythos. Nobody. It's actually one of the truisms I have and one of the reasons I look at terminating Leverage not in year 10 is nobody has a good year 6. Right. You know.
I'm legally required, I guess, to ask at this point, what do you think of Portland, John?
I love Portland. Seriously considering getting a place up here. It's really, we were going to shoot at Portland State Engineering and walking out of the hotel, and I said, how do we get there? And the girl says, well, just go down, take a right, and there's the train, and you're in the fareless zone, so just hop in the train, it takes you right there, two stops. And Chris Downey and I were on the train going, this city's got it figured out. This is great, you know?
We're sort of a, we're kind of a roach motel for artists where they, you know, they come here and you would think that, you know, the roaches, they would warn their brethren, but they never do. They always say, come on in, it's great.
Fantastic.
And then it's 10,000 of them, but, you know, so we're...
It's got Powell's, it's got, you've got real nature both inside the city and outside the city. You've got a real great comic book scene up here, actually, so, and a great music scene. It's a fantastic city. I'm glad we're here.
Talking to John Rogers, the man behind Leverage. We will continue this conversation. We return next right here on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there. I'm Rick Emerson. And just as we are loyal to our marquee sponsor, Things From Another World, based right here in Portland, Oregon, they are loyal to you, their valued customer. It's time to talk about their customer loyalty program. And here's how it works. It works with stamp cards. Not green stamps and not the collectible A&P stamps like your grandmother had. Kind of like that, but not really. There's comic stamps. There are graphic novel stamps. Essentially, every time you buy a comic book valued at $2.99 or more, you get a stamp. You get 10 of those, and you get a comic book of your choice, $3.99 or less, absolutely free. With the graphic novel stamps, every time you buy a graphic novel valued at $14.99 or more, you're going to get yourself a graphic novel stamp. You buy 10, and you get another of your choice valued at $19.99 or less, absolutely free. Free, nada, zero, nothing, zilch, the big donut, my friends. This offer is good at their physical locations, so find out more about those physical locations at tfaw.com. tfaw.com. Ask about Things From Another World and their customer loyalty program. Things From Another World. No matter what you're into, they have just the thing for your collection.